beautiful because of Jesus. He has given us life and life so abundantly.
Now give your friend a high five and tell them I did better than you. Woo. Wonderful, wonderful. All right, see you later. Bye.
You're welcome, children. Wherever you are, I want you to rise up on your feet and join us as we sing this song together. Are you ready? We go. Whoa, oh, 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 oh. Come on, jump. We go. Uh-huh.
Never let go, never let go of you.
Never let go.
Connect. My name is Jennifer Musali, and next to me is
Abigail Iraguha. I'm 9 years old.
Hi, everybody. My name is Auntie Christabel, all the way from Watoto Children's Church, Lubowa. And on my right is
Hannah Iraguha. I'm 13 years old.
Hi, Hannah. Hi, everybody. Hello, children. Welcome to Kids Connect. So today, we are going to understand more about what we learned last Sunday. Do we all remember what we learned about last Sunday?
Last Sunday, we learned about honoring the Sabbath day.
And what do we know about honoring the Sabbath day? Jennifer?
What we know of is that when we honor the Sabbath day, we are honoring God.
Wonderful. Yes, Abigail, what did you learn about the Sabbath day, honoring the Sabbath day?
We go to church and praise the Lord.
We go to church and praise the Lord. Children, did you go to church? Did you praise the Lord? Did you actually take time to say thank you, Lord, for this Sabbath? Yes, Hannah, anything else that we learned about?
We learned that on the Sabbath, we should stop everything that we are doing and focus on God and give Him thanks.
Amen. We should stop everything that we are doing. Focus on God, rest, take time with your family, make sure you're eating nice food. How many of us ate nice food on Sunday? You ate? What did you eat?
I ate beef and rice.
Beef and rice. Jennifer, what did you eat?
I ate pizza.
Pizza. Ah, wow, nice. What did you eat, Abigail?
I ate beef and rice.
Beef and rice. Okay, pizza, beef and rice. Those are nice meals to have on a Sunday because we are honoring the Sabbath. Now, today, we have a wonderful opportunity to have to understand how to honor the people around us. And we're going to read from our scripture in 1 John chapter 4, verse 20. And Abigail is going to read for us from the Bible. 1 John chapter 4. Yes.
We're going to read from 1 John chapter 4.
Verse 20.
It says, if someone says, I love God, but hates a Christian, brother or sister, that person is a liar. For if we don't love people we can see, how can we love God whom we cannot see?
Very wonderful. Now, children, ask yourself, how can I love God? How can I say I love God? I honor God. I worship God. And yet I don't love Hannah. And yet I don't love Abigail. And yet I don't love Jennifer. Is that love? Is that love?
No.
It's not love. So how can we practically love God, especially the people that are closest to us? You show love to the people that are closest to us, and the people that are more close to us are our parents, right?
Yes.
Yes. So if we are to love our parents, if we are to honor our parents, there are so many ways that we can honor them. So what are some of the ways that we can show love to our parents, to the people that are closest to us? Yes, Jennifer?
By obeying what they tell us to do.
Do you obey your parents?
Yes.
What do you do when they tell you to do something?
I reply to them and go ahead and do what they have told me to do.
Oh, wonderful. Abigail, what else can we do to show love to our parents, to show love to mommy or daddy?
By doing what they love.
Like what? What do they love?
Spending time with each other.
Spending time with each other. So you also spend time with them.
Yes.
So that they feel loved. That's wonderful. That is an amazing one. Children, learn to spend time with your parents. When you spend time with your parents, it shows that you appreciate them. It shows that you love them. Because sometimes the parents also come from work, they are tired and what. But when you take some time and you go and sit with them and you say, oh, mommy, how was your day? What did you get to do today? It shows that you love them. Hannah, could you tell us some of the things that you do to show that you love your parents?
When my parents tell me to do my chores, I do them.
Do you do chores?
Yes.
What chores do you do, Hannah?
I cook food.
What food do you like to cook?
I like to cook chicken and beef.
Oh, you know how to cook chicken and beef. Wonderful. Yes. Any other thing? Jennifer, what else can you do to show your parents that you love and appreciate them?
By obeying what they tell us to do.
Like what?
Like, for example, laying your bed and
spending time with them and the family.
And the family. It's very important for us to spend time as a family because our parents also love to spend time with us. And when we do what they tell us, it's very important that mommy can tell you, go and wash your feet, go and wash dishes, go and make beds. But if you refuse, that means you don't love them. We don't like to do the things they tell us all the time, but sometimes we do them because we love them. Not so. What other things do we do that we might not like, but we do because mommy, we want to show mommy that we love her, or we want to show daddy that we love him? Any other thing you can think of?
We do our chores even though we don't want to do them.
What are your least interesting chores?
Cleaning the house.
Cleaning the house. Oh, Jennifer, what don't you like to do much, but you must do?
Organizing my drawer.
Organizing your drawer. What is in that drawer? There's so much. You just can't.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, Abigail. What chores are those you can't? You want to do? Sometimes you're like, if I could dodge this one, I would not do.
Washing my clothes.
Washing your clothes. Yeah, washing is quite a challenging thing, but we do it because it will make mommy happy. It will make daddy happy, and it shows how much we love them and appreciate them. And most times, when you do these things, our parents are proud of us. Our parents are happy. They are excited because these are the things that make parents happy. So, even when you perform well in school, are your parents happy? Do they love you when
they
you
are?
So, how are you performing in school, Hannah? Are you making mommy smile?
Yes,
oh,
I
really?
Am.
Jennifer, what else do you do at school, at home that shows how much you love mommy and daddy?
I buy them gifts.
Oh, wow. What gifts do they love? What gifts that mommy love?
Necklaces, watches, bags.
Bags. Wow. What about daddy?
He loves watches, belts, and books.
Oh, wow. So how do you get this money to buy all these wonderful, amazing gifts?
They put money in our saving jars that we can use at the end of the year to buy them gifts for Christmas.
Wonderful. So that's also an amazing way to show our parents that we love them. Children, you should start saving. In case you don't have the money yet, start saving to show love at the end of the year. It's very important for us to know that our parents love to be appreciated. That's another way of appreciating them. When you buy a gift with your money, your savings, you have not thought about yourself, but you've thought about your mom, you've thought about your dad, and that gift is going to go a long way in their heart. In their life, they'll always feel like, my little girl thought about me, my wonderful son thought about me. Even if it's not a necklace, even if it's not a belt, but anything small. I love chocolate, and I would be so excited to just even receive a chocolate. So let's not say, oh me, I can't save for a bag, I can't save for, but the little things, anything your mom loves, anything your dad loves, anything you can afford, you can save. If you save 200 shillings today, 200 shillings tomorrow, but don't save God's money. God's money is for church. You save other money that you're given that is extra, and then you give it for, you use it to buy your parents gifts. Amen? So, we know that God reminds us that when we love our parents, our lives will be made longer in this earth. Do we all understand what it means to have a long life because of being obedient? Yes, Abigail. Do you understand what it means when the Bible says we love our parents so that our lives on earth will be made longer?
Yes, I do.
Tell us more about that.
Like you live longer and you stay on earth for a long time.
You live longer and you stay on earth for a long time. Children, don't you want to stay until you find gray hair on your head, long gray hair, until you see your great-grandchildren, until you see the world and you're like, I have seen everything in this world. It's a wonderful thing. And you know how you can achieve that? Love and respect your parents. Respect your father. Respect your mother. Everything you do, it's very important because God knows your heart. God knows what you are doing, and he will make sure that, Jennifer has to live long. Abigail has to live long. Hannah has to live long. Christabel has to live long in this earth because they have respected their parents. They have loved their parents. So everything that we do, we always must know we need to honor our parents. We need to honor our guardians. Sometimes our parents may not be around, but we have the aunties and uncles, those aunties who help us at home. Do we have them? Hannah, do you have them? How do you respect them?
We listen to what they tell us
to do. You listen to what they tell them. Yes, Abigail. How do you honor those aunties at home?
By loving them.
By loving them. She shows them love. Children, you can hug them. Sometimes they help us to do a lot of things, but it's okay to give them a hug and say thank you. So today, we have learned about honoring and loving our parents. Don't forget to go an extra mile, buy a gift, give them a hug, tell them something, write them a note. Some parents just love to read from us. We have very beautiful handwritings, and we can do that. We can use the handwriting to make them happy. And today, we know that as we go home, we are all going to do exactly that and love our parents and show them appreciation so that our days on earth will be long. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
So, thank you very much for coming. Now, we are going to speak to the children who want to receive God in their lives. There are so many ways. Maybe you're very disobedient. Maybe the devil makes you do things sometimes that you're not sure of. You want to respect mommy and daddy, but the devil tells you other things. But today, you want to say no to Satan, no to the devil's schemes, and you want to give your life to Jesus. We are going to pray with you, and you're going to repeat this prayer after me, and you give your life to Jesus. Hands together.
Eyes closed.
Let's pray. Dear God,
I
thank you.
I thank you
for loving me.
For loving me.
And creating me.
And creating me.
With parents.
With parents.
Aunties.
Aunties.
Uncles.
Uncles.
Who love me.
Who love me.
I pray. And ask.
And ask.
That you will help me.
That you will help me.
To love them.
To love them.
To respect them.
To respect them.
And to obey them.
And to obey them.
Jesus,
I ask you
to come and be the king of my life.
And be the king of my life.
Teach me to love you.
Teach me to love you.
Teach me your ways.
Teach me your ways.
So that I will be your child.
So that I will be your child.
Transform me.
Transform me.
And help me.
And help me.
To be in your kingdom.
To be in your kingdom.
Today.
Today.
I invite you. Into my heart.
Into my heart.
As my Lord.
As my Lord.
And my Savior.
And my Savior.
In Jesus' name we've prayed. And all God's children say.
Amen.
Now. Children, thank you very much for coming today. Me and my friends are going to say bye to you. We shall definitely see you next Sunday. From all of us to you,
bye.
So children, we serve a God who is our provider. He is able to meet all our needs. So wherever you are, children, I want you to just join us and let's sing this together, that Jesus is our provider. He is sufficient. Are you ready to sing with us, children? Come on.
You are sufficient for me, more than I'll ever need, more than enough, abounding in love. You are my everything.
Let me hear you sing these words.
You are sufficient.
More than enough,
abounding in love. You
You can call him your sustainer. He's your El Shaddai. So as we sing these names out, I want you to sing them out like you mean them, children. Are you ready to sing them out with us? Together.
our trust is in Him. Are you ready to sing that we have hope? Let's sing it again.